This year is the 150th anniversary of the periodic table, the classic arrangement of elements everybody meets in basic chemistry. One of the many great things about the periodic table is that each element has a letter or two that represents it. For example, UConn spells uranium, cobalt, nitrogen, nitrogen. We've all probably heard of uranium before. You can tell from its spot at the bottom of the periodic table that it's a very large atom. And because it's so big, it can bond with up to 12 other atoms. But have you ever considered cobalt? Cobalt gets its name from kobold, the German word for goblin. And it's a tricky element, as prospectors in Cobalt, Connecticut found in the 18th century, when a vein of cobalt ore was discovered. Several groups of miners came, but investors always lost interest, and each project stalled. Cobalt is in the middle of the periodic table. It's smaller than uranium, so it can only bond with 6 other atoms at a time. It likes to bond with elements like oxygen, sulfur, and arsenic, which is just how it was found in the Connecticut vein. Gold is a similar size, but it wasn't until 1989 that a UConn field study found gold, including pure nuggets in plain sight, running parallel to the cobalt. Were the miners hiding something? We may never know. But we do know about nitrogen. It makes up 70% of the air we breathe. Nitrogen is small. It can only bond with up to 3 other atoms at a time. And it prefers to bond to itself, which is how it's found in the air, and in UConn. The size of the elements is only one of the many amazing facts embodied in the periodic table. The table is one of the crowning achievements of human thought, a way of understanding and sorting the universe. Or, well, spelling the universe. Here's to another 150 years.